Now, still on the sidelines of the AMVCA, Nollywood actress and producer Rekia Ibrahimata says local language content is getting more investment, and there's still gaps that present opportunities for investors looking to plow money into the movie industry in Africa. Take a look.
I think the growth is almost like at 60-70%, you know, rolling out all the time. The growth is phenomenal. I remember when it started, it wasn't... Come on, this is the seventh edition of the AMVCA and it's the viewer's, you know, choice, you know. I think that the growth is really wonderful. I'm excited to still be here and be part of the industry. Yeah.
Now, over the years, there's been call for more patronage for cinema movies. Mm-hmm. But what's the cinema culture like among Nigerians?
Cinema culture is growing. I mean, it never used to be like this. I go to a place like Kebbi and there's a cinema. Come on, it's growing. And that means that Nigerians are becoming more aware of that entertainment window and they're calling for more, you know, content to come to cinemas, especially when you can, within 5 minutes, get to a cinema. I think it's nice. It's growing.
So we've seen the emergence, or the growth rather, of indigenous movies in our local dialects, like Hausa, Yoruba movies. What's the appetite like for such movies outside our shores?
I think if you look at, around the West Africa coast, there are a lot of Hausa-speaking people, for instance, and they're clamoring for more content. I think, as a producer, I recently produced something in Hausa, 26-episode, you know, series of a family show. So I think people are putting their money more into the language content because people also want to identify with their culture and hear their language at, you know, various levels. So I think that it is also growing, and more people should think about producing in local languages as well.
You talked about putting money into movies in Nigeria. What are the investment opportunities? If an investor is listening to this interview, where can they put their money and get returns in Nigeria's movie industry?
Well, in Nigeria's movie, it's almost like every aspect of the Nigerian movie industry is viable. Do you want to do cinemas? Do you want to do series? Do you want to do, you know, there's several, you know, gaps there that we have not been able to tap yet. So I think that with a careful study of the platform, there's so many places where, you know, investors can. They just need to understand it, because usually some of these investors are not part of the industry. So they look at it like, you know, not too sure. But I think that as practitioners, we should explain it to them more and get them to understand exactly what it is that we're talking about, and then they will come on.
You made reference to gaps in the, and to some gaps that investors could fill in. Is there a role government could play to fill in those gaps as well?
Oh, certainly. When we say that there are gaps, first and foremost, what creates those gaps? You understand? There isn't so much that the industry practitioners can do by themselves. We're talking policies here. We're talking laws that can guide some of the structures that the industry survives on. So certainly we do need the participation of government, active participation of government, active conscious participation of government, really, to support the industry to grow, because the industry can be a leading revenue for Nigeria.
And that was Rekia Ibrahimata. She's a Nollywood actress and producer. And that's a wrap on Beyond Markets. And thank you so much for being a part of the show today. Remember, you can watch the show at 5 p.m. West African time daily and have access to all previous episodes of Beyond Markets on our website. That's at CNBC Africa. You can also stay engaged with the hashtag Beyond Markets and follow me at Kenneth Igbomo. Have a wonderful day.